Now, folks who live up in northern sections of the greater Baltimore area, of course, they know how to deal with this type of snow. 11 News reporter Kai Reed is live in northern Baltimore County with a look at how folks are dealing with it. And, Kai, we want to know, first of all, how are you dealing with it? We can barely see you through it.
We are doing pretty well, Tom. It's beautiful, isn't it? I mean, it really makes for a really pretty picture, but the drive is not so pleasant. The visibility is very poor, and although a lot of the main roads, like Bel Air Road here behind me, look pretty good, the side roads are pretty snow-covered. Those are a problem in a lot of these areas. At this point, road crews and drivers are just trying to make the best of it. The new year brings a new batch of snow to contend with. Snow-covered roads, cars, and drivers willing to bear it all in order to pick up the necessities.
We got the usual, the milk and the bread and anything that'll keep us warm and toasty.
We got diapers, we got meat, cereal, stuff for dogs.
Carroll, northern Baltimore, and Harford counties are under a winter storm warning until 5 a.m. Crews in Harford County started pre-treating the roads late this afternoon before the snow started. They're expecting as much as 6 inches of snow by morning.
Our highway crews, we have approximately 100 personnel, will be out till at least midnight, and then we'll come back out at 4 a.m. and we'll return to plowing and treating the roads in order for folks to get to work tomorrow morning.
Emergency officials warn of slick roads and possibly a delay on clearing some side streets.
To try to slow down, allow enough distance between yourself and a vehicle in front of you and around you.
And while some are thinking about managing the snow, others are thinking about playing in it. Nicole Davis and her two-year-old son are wishing that they'd planned ahead.
He said he wanted a snow sled and then reminded me. And I was like, oh, I don't feel like traveling, you know. But I said, you know what, let's go ahead and try to, you know, work through the snow. Came here, they don't have any snow sleds. So off to home we go.
They're going to have to do without some sleds, at least for tonight and tomorrow. Now, Rob Thomas from Harford County Emergency Management said that those trucks, those road crews, are taking the break from midnight to 4 just to make sure that they're completely rested and ready to go at full steam to get ready for that morning commute. We did, by the way, call around to a lot of the counties in this area, and they did say that they have not reported or they haven't experienced a lot of major accidents, just a few fender benders, but they are asking people, reminding people again, to stay off the roads if you don't need to be out here. For now, reporting live from northern Baltimore County, Kai Reed, WBAL TV 11 News.
All right, Kai. And tonight, state highway administration officials are reminding Maryland motorists to be extra cautious on the roads as they will continue to be slick. 11 News reporter George Lettis continues our team coverage with that part of the story. He's live tonight in Hanover. George?
Well, hey there, Stan. Yeah, it's interesting. Kai Reed's live shot had a lot of horizontal snow. We're still pretty much vertical, or at least 45-degree angle here, so you see the difference in the regions of what people are getting as far as wind and snow. As far as the highways, Kai Reed said it, state highway officials say not many major incidents, but they are still concerned overnight about the drop in temperatures and that low visibility for tomorrow. 's commute home is Linthicum to Alexandria, Virginia.
Probably slowly. I'm pregnant, so have to be careful.
Christina Welsh is going from Linthicum to White Marsh.
I am apprehensive. I got in an accident once when I was younger in the snow, and now it makes me nervous.
Secondary and side roads were no cakewalk in Anne Arundel County tonight. Aviation Boulevard near BWI Marshall Airport presented drivers with a healthy covering of snow and sleet. Some were not pleased.
No, not at all. I didn't believe it. I didn't think it would get this cold and snow this quick.
Some relished the opportunity.
I love it. I think it's great. We wait all year for it to snow because we have all-wheel drive cars, and both my wife and me, she has snow tires on her all-wheel drive car. She's at work. I'm not even worried about it.
Either way, the State Highway Administration's Operations Center will be busy all night monitoring highway road conditions thanks to its statewide camera network.
Really want to stay on guard for freezing, icy conditions. That's also added to the winds that we might be seeing, blowing snow, visibility will be reduced.
The one big message from the state tonight, don't drive if you don't have to.
Let our crews get out there, treat the roads. It only takes one disabled vehicle, one major crash to really tie up traffic, and then all our trucks get stuck in the same traffic backups as everyone else. It hampers efforts. They're just not able to treat the roads.
And we're told throughout the night there will be about 2,000 salt and plow trucks on the roads to battle this storm. We're live in Hanover, George Lettis, WBAL-TV 11 News.